Hi guys. Back in this series of videos, I built Linnae and Hydra, my video editing workstation, whose data storage is three SSDs and a RAID 0 stripe that give me 1.6 gigabyte per second read speeds and 1.2 gigabyte per second write speeds. The RAID itself is handled by the motherboard via Intel's RST, or Rapid Storage Technology. And the aim of this video is to show you the different RAID options that are available and the kind of performance that you can expect using various combinations of drives and also the various stripe sizes. I'm not going to go into the details on how RAID works, although given the amount of misinformation I see online, particularly around SSD RAID arrays, I might do a video on that in the future. I'm going to assume that you know the difference between RAID 0, RAID 10 and RAID 5. If you don't and you need me to do a video on that in the future, just let me know in the comments. So for these tests, I'm using five 250GB Samsung 850 EVO SSDs, and I'm running the test on the Linnae Hydra, which is packing an ASUS X99 Sabertooth motherboard, an 8-core Intel Core i7 5960 Extreme Edition processor, overclocked to 4.5GHz, paired with 32GB of Corsair Vengeance DDR4 RAM. It's also worth noting that on the X99 chipset, or in fact any recent chipset pre-Skylake, communication between the CPU and the SATA storage subsystem is via DMI 2.0, which is a maximum bandwidth of 20 gigabits per second. And that link is shared with your USB 3, USB 2 and Ethernet ports, as well as the onboard audio and PCIe 2.0 slots. If we subtract those from the 20 gigabits, we end up with around 12 to 14 gigabits a second, which is available for the SATA system. And that works out to around 1.5 to 1.7 gigabytes per second. And yes, with some SSD SATA RAID configurations, we'll easily bump into that limitation. So let's start off with RAID 0. What sort of performance do we see with 2, 3, 4 and even 5 disk stripes? First, the read speeds. This is a single SSD drive, which offers a peak read speed of around 530 megabytes per second. With a 2-disk stripe, we see peak speeds of over 1,100 megabytes per second, which is roughly twice as fast, and we maintain that speed over a wide range of file sizes. Moving on to a 3-disk stripe, we again see huge gains, with peak read speeds now hitting 1,600 megabytes per second. Great stuff. So let's add a 4th drive to the set. What happened here? It's a little faster, 1,640 megs, but why such a small gain? Some sort of diminishing return of RAID 0? No. Remember the DMI 2.0 bottleneck I mentioned earlier? We just hit it. Let's add a 5th drive just because we can. Same story, no more gains. If your processor uses DMI 2.0 for communication with your chipset, there is no performance benefit running more than, well, 3 drives really, in a RAID 0 set. Let's take a look at writes though. Again, this is the performance of a single SSD drive. Peak write speed is 520 megabytes per second. With a 2-drive stripe, that rises to 965 megabytes per second on large files. Pretty cool. If we add a 3rd drive to the stripe set, we can hit 1170 megs a second. A 4th takes us to a spotty 1205, and a 5th takes us to 1245 megabytes per second. So again, 3 drives is about optimal. Now let's take a look at RAID 10. This could be built out of 4 or 6 SSD drives, but I only have 5 to hand, so a 4-drive array it was. Again, here's the read performance of a single SSD drive. And this is the RAID 10 array, 1640 megs a second. With 4 drives available to read from, we've basically run straight into that DMI 2.0 wall. Now let's take a look at writes again. Here's a single SSD drive, and here's the 4-drive RAID 10 array. We hit 625 megabytes per second. Now, if you're wondering why 4 drives can't do any better than that, that's because that unlike in reads, where they all read in parallel, in writes you're writing the same data to half the drives. So we can't expect the speed to be any better than a 2-drive RAID 0 stripe. But we're a lot slower than a simple 2-disk stripe, as remember, we're also writing the data to another pair of drives at the same time. So for performance reasons, at least on reads, there's no point in using any more than 4 drives in a RAID 10 array. Now let's take a look at RAID 5 that tries to strike a balance between the speed of a RAID 0 stripe and the data protection of a mirroring technology. Now, RAID 5 needs at least 3 drives, so here are the figures for that. 1,510 megs at peak, which is within a hair of our 3-disk RAID 0 array. There are no prizes for guessing what happens when I add the results for the 4th. And then 5th drive sets. We hit 1582 megabytes per second. So yes, we're saturating that link again. For maximum read performance, there's really no point in going beyond 3 drives in a RAID 5 set. Now let's take a look at writes. You all know what this is by now. If you don't know, RAID 5 has to calculate parity for all the bits we're writing to the disk, so performance here depends on how much horsepower you have to throw at it. In fact, in days gone by, you'd need an add-in RAID card to handle this for you unless you wanted things to move at an absolute snail's pace. With modern processors, we don't need to be quite as concerned. In fact, I was watching the CPU usage of the 5960X during the benchmarks, and all the cores appeared to be idling. So here's the 3-disk RAID 5 array, peaking at 565 megabytes per second. The 4-disk array hits 710, which is better than the 4-disk RAID 10 managed. At 5 disks, we're down slightly to 690 megabytes per second. I don't have a 6 drive to add to the array to test my theory on this, but I'm wondering if the parity calculation is just too expensive with more drives, or if it improves at all with an even number like 6. If you have a 6 disk array and can post results in the comments, I'd appreciate it. With the numbers I have, I'd say there's no point in going beyond 4 disks in a RAID 5 array when using the motherboard RAID. When it comes to performance, these seem to be the optimum configurations using the X99 motherboard RAID on my system. The read performance of a 3-disc RAID 0 set, a 4-disc RAID 10 set, and a 4-disc RAID 5 set are all basically the same. When it comes to writes, there's a larger difference. Here we can see our 4-drive RAID 10 set isn't much faster than a single SSD drive, and it's actually beaten, although not by much, by the 4-disc RAID 5 set. The clear winner for heavy write workloads is the RAID 0 stripe, which hits nearly 1200 megabytes a second using just 3 drives, and that's why I use it in my rig. Now, I haven't discussed stripe size, which is another parameter that you can adjust when you're creating your RAID array, and it can make a big difference to the performance numbers. In fact, in all the previous slides that I've shown, I've already pre-selected the best stripe size for each of the different types of RAID configuration. I will include charts at the end of this video that show you the performance of the different RAID configs with different stripe sizes so that you can see the numbers for yourself. I run RAID 0 arrays on all my machines because I need the speed. And before anyone howls about the loss of data, let me just say, I'm not worried about it. And you really shouldn't be either. RAID systems are not backups. They protect you from the failure of typically one drive, and they let you keep working while that drive gets replaced. That's their sole purpose. Whether you're running a RAID 0 stripe, a RAID mirror, or even a RAID 6 array with 2 spare drives, you need regular, scheduled, and tested backups. I'll make a video about backup strategies in the future, but for now, just know that I can restore all my data quicker than your RAID 5 array can rebuild. And if your data isn't important enough for you to be backing up regularly and testing those backups as well, because a backup that you haven't tested is not a backup. If you're not doing any of that, why are you so worried about RAID 0? I hope this video on motherboard SSD RAID options and performance was useful. If it was, hit that like button. If you disagree with anything that I've said, let me know in the comments. And if you find the videos useful and you want to see more, hit that subscribe button.